How long can an earthquake last for where people can feel the ground continuously shaking? While many people think of earthquakes as only lasting for a few seconds, perhaps a few tens of seconds, ground motion during an earthquake can in fact last for significantly longer. Take, for example, these three earthquakes which occurred in 2025. The recent magnitude 6.9 Philippines earthquake shook the ground for about 35 seconds. The magnitude 7.7 Myanmar earthquake earlier in the year shook the ground for 82.7 seconds. And the very large magnitude 8.8 megathrust earthquake in Russia on July 30th caused the ground to move for a full 191.8 seconds. That's right, for a full 3 minutes and 11.8 seconds. That particular, unusually lengthy earthquake not only created a damaging tsunami that ran up to 15 meters or 49 feet above sea level, but was also the 6th largest earthquake ever recorded during the era of modern seismic equipment. And yet, despite this fact, its duration didn't even rank among the top 10 longest earthquakes. So, how long exactly can a major earthquake last for? And, to clarify, I am not referring to slow slip events which aren't detectable by people, only sensors, and can sometimes last for years or decades. The answer? Not 5 minutes, not 7 minutes, but a whopping 10 minutes. Yes, just imagine having trouble standing due to an earthquake for a full 10 minutes. It would feel like an eternity. While a hypothetical building might survive very strong shaking if it lasts for 10 seconds, a favorable outcome is far less likely if continuous non-stop ground motion occurs for a full 10 minutes. And yet, that is exactly what occurred during the planet's largest known historical earthquake in 1960, when, in Chile, a megathrust earthquake with a magnitude of 9.5 caused incredibly widespread and catastrophic damage. After all, the larger magnitude of an earthquake that occurs, the longer the amount of a fault that slips, and the greater the amount of time it takes for this to happen. But what exactly do I mean by an earthquake's duration? This might seem like a question with a self-explanatory answer when in fact it isn't. To show you exactly what I mean, take for example this magnitude 7.05 earthquake which struck high in the Himalayas in southwestern China on January 7, 2025. Based on this data provided, how long do you think the earthquake lasted for? You probably think the earthquake started when the ground shaking first rose above zero and ended when it reached zero again, in this case translating to 29.9 seconds. Yet, that was not the official length of this magnitude 7.05 earthquake. Instead, the earthquake only lasted for 23.1 seconds. But why? As it turns out, a definition is involved. And this definition is used by scientists for an important reason. Many factors such as, but not limited to, the regional geology, nature of surface landforms, amount of groundwater, and existence or not of subsurface magma can change the length ground shaking is detectable for, especially in cases where seismic waves bounce off of an object and reflect backwards. That is why the official definition for a length of an earthquake is the initial onset of seismic waves until it first declines to 10% of its peak value. That methodology attempts to remove possible seismic wave reflection that might be seen at the end of such a chart. But, with this in mind, why did this week's large magnitude 6.9 earthquake in the Philippines lead to a wide range of reports from people who are very confident in remembering how long ground shaking lasted for at their location? Specifically, figures reported to me range from 10 seconds all the way to 60 seconds. Are these people simply misremembering? Surprisingly, no. The figures they gave are likely correct. The key thing to remember here is that these people were at various distances from the quake's epicenter and were at the time on a number of different rock units. Seismic waves move more slowly through areas with abundant sediment as it is harder for them to propagate through non-solid bedrock, meaning ground motion from an earthquake on sediment would last longer than on, say, granite. Also, there are three types of seismic waves with different speeds. If you are far enough away from an earthquake, it can be seconds or even minutes between when the P wave, S wave, and surface waves arrive. This means that if you can still feel the ground shaking from an earthquake, it will seemingly last longer, albeit with some potential pauses the further away from an earthquake's epicenter you are located.